We have all assembled here to upgrade ourselves from one level to another level. We are all doctors here, claiming to cure any disease. Are we doctors? Or are we healers? Are we the curers? If you ask yourself, definitely you will say no. What disease can you cure? Can you cure every disease on the earth? I say an emphatic no. If it is so, are we fit enough to call ourselves doctors, however great we are? You can be allopathist, you can be acupuncturist, you can be naturopathist, you can be Siddha, Ayurveda, whatever it is. Are we so definite we can cure all diseases? When we say no, then we have to be very humble before the people, and I must have enough hesitation to call myself a doctor. I will have to practice utmost humility, restrict myself with enough enthusiasm to stay humble before the people. This is the first thing we will understand. I am not a doctor, I want to be a doctor. That could be your aim. Even if you can cure certain diseases, you will not know whether you will cure another disease of like nature. Cannot. If I am able to cure cancer, one cancer, it doesn't mean I can cure all cancers. It is impossible for me to say I can cure. But is it a luck then? One person with cancer, if he is cured, is it a luck? You can call so. When you don't know how a cure has affected, it is a luck. We have come here to know there is no luck here, but it is the belief in one's heart by which he approaches a patient. When we are approaching a patient confidently, when we are approaching a patient with hope, when we are approaching the patient with belief, what if we approach the patient with faith? What is the difference by which we are approaching a patient? With confidence you are approaching, with hope you are approaching a patient, with belief you are treating a patient, with faith you wait for the cure to occur. Prayerfully, soulfully, intentionally, I am prayerful. What is the difference between the confidence level, hope, belief and faith? We have come to know here a different level of understanding, that is belief and faith. So far we have been practicing with confidence and with hope. Confidence is the lowest level of one's ability. Faith is the highest level of God's providence. Between the lowest level and the highest level, we have been toggling between the ups and downs. One need to understand why this happens. In certain cases, I am able to cure diseases. In certain cases, I am not able to cure diseases. So what is the purpose of my being here? We are to elevate ourselves from a confidence level to a hopeful level. Confidence means I believe I can do. I have my subject. I am so confident, definitely I can cure this disease. I can do certain things. Certain things. With whatever knowledge I possess, with whatever experience I have, I will be able to do certain things. With the knowledge I am possessing and with the experience I got, I will be able to do certain things. Not all things. So this is confidence. I know I can do. Coming to the understanding of what I know of my experiences, I know what I have read, and I know what I have learned from hearsay, I know proof from the proof of the documents, certain things I have read. All these things are from my past. What I am is for my future. I am living only for the coming days. Whatever gone past of me, it is bygone. I cannot go back to my past and start working on that level. All are dead days. Our knowledge is a dead knowledge and it's a deadly knowledge because the knowledge is from the dead past of my experiences. If we understand past cannot come to the present and it cannot edge towards the future. Past can never come back. Whoever is dead cannot come back alive. If that is true, past will not come to our future. My past knowledge, I know, it has to improve further and further. My past knowledge has to improve further and it has to improve still further, endlessly. That is knowledge. So at any point of time, knowledge is half-baked. Knowledge, when I am using, I become half-hearted. No enthusiasm at all because it's a old and stale knowledge. I cannot use it to the present. I must have an elevated knowledge, an improved understanding, and better ability to tackle the future problems. Whether you will have future problems or not, definitely I will have my problems in the future. What are the diseases you will contract in the future? I am not able to say. Tomorrow I may be suffering, tomorrow I may be healthy, but can I dictate it today? I will be leading a life of this manner tomorrow. It is impossible. So here we shall understand we have to be constantly elevating our standards. We will never use our knowledge of the past, but we will understand what is present today, how I am able to manipulate the present situation from evil to better. How will I do it? I am suffering from something. I do not know what I am suffering from. I am only using certain knowledge by which I have heard of someone curing. I have myself experienced curing someone of the knowledge I possessed, so I am using that to cure the present problem of some other people also. So this is confidence. Confidence is very, very lowest level of your ability. You are able to put in force the knowledge you have already possessed of the past. So this past knowledge cannot be applicable today because we are live, we are living. We are always live to the situation. We are not dead. We are looking forward to. So the present life and future life is what we are going through, what we have to pass through. But the past knowledge has to be totally abandoned. Past knowledge has to be forgotten. Today, past knowledge will not be effective. A human mind is always unseen. It is a force. So today when I am challenged with something, whether you can cure certain disease, because you claimed you have cured certain diseases, whether you can cure this disease, the whole world wants to see, now I have some jitteriness. I have some fear in me. So I have some anxiety. Is it possible or not? This is the real nature. So now I say, I am confident of curing the disease, I will not say, because the fear has already gripped me. I will say, I hope. So there is something beyond me which comes into effect. Then only I will be able to see some results, which I am hoping to. So I hope I can do it. When I say that, it means I have no confidence, but I still think that it may be cured from some other superior force. I may be able to cure this. This is the hope. You are elevating to a second stage. From the lowest level of confidence, you are elevating to a hope level. Confidence plays a part, and hope plays a major part. This we can call as luck would have it. If my lucks are in my favor, I will be able to do certain things. But I will not say I am confident of doing it. Let me try, I will say. Let us hope things will become all right. This is a probable humility you have definitely imposed on yourself when you are challenged, when the fear grips you. You have to elevate further, even above this hope level. I believe things may be in my favor. There is no confidence here. The lower level of two mental abilities are gone, that is confidence and a hope with little bit of confidence still attaching to it. When that confidence totally is eliminated, it is between the hope and belief. I have hope and I believe so. Let us hope so. Let us believe so. We are elevating further. We are becoming more humble. I know nothing. I will not be able to claim that I am a doctor of all diseases. I will be able to cure all diseases. All those things will go. You are elevating mentally. That mind power now you are getting when you are elevating from the confidence to hope level to belief level. When you say, I believe I can do it, that means totally your confidence is thrashed, eliminated. It is like a dust, it is removed. You are now toggling between the hope and belief. Belief means less of hope and more of belief. You are not basing your success on the luck, but you are basing your success on the belief. What is belief now? That belief is there is something more to what we know. Definitely it is existing. Hope level, that part we have not understood. There's something beyond my ability and beyond my capacity. There is something which will come to my help. I will not be thinking on that level when I am toggling between the confident and hope level. When the confidence is removed as a dust and kicked out, now I am toggling between hope and belief level. I am elevating. There is a power above me. So I am now hopeful. I have some hope and I have some belief, both things. Hope is a lower level, belief is a higher level. Hope means you are attaching to your luck. Belief means you are attaching that there is something above you. Definitely you are wanting that power to act on you, to come to your help. This is the belief level. Elevate further up. This belief is gaining strength as days go by. And the strength thus gathered comes your way very near to you to help you in all your endeavors. There is no more effort on our part because I know nothing. When the belief plays major part, I have to be totally effortless. I will not be worrying about things. I will not give high-flown words to the patients. I will not make them believe that I am treating the patient. Let us believe things should happen the right way. So that belief is important. When some patient comes to you, they believe you and come. They don't hope that this person may cure and then I go there. I believe, so this doctor can cure, I come here. If you have got that name among the public, that means you are a believer, not even a person who will be believing in their luck and hopes, but you are a believer above the level of hope. So you will not give your unnecessary, unwanted certainty, I am going to cure. You will never pose yourself as a leader of cure, but He will be humble before them, let us believe. But there is your great energy in your voice, the lively energy in your voice. You'll be able to take that word to the heart of the patient. If I am able to touch the heart of the patient, I am on a better scale. I am on a better level of ability to cure the patient. This belief gains strength, and as days go by, hope is gone. You will not be believing in luck anymore, but you will be believing in the power above. So you become faithful to that power. Now the divinity starts helping you all the way in your every effort, and it will guide you who will be cured, who will not be cured also. It is not that you have come here to cure everybody. It is by God's providence. If He wills, he will be cured. If He doesn't, He will not be cured. So you have to assess the patient before taking them into your stride. This is the way that we are going to behave from this moment onwards. Don't have any confidence. That is, don't believe in the knowledge. Knowledge has to grow forever. Every moment it has to grow. So any point of time, whether it is the 21st century or 21,000th century, the knowledge is always half-baked. If we believe in that half-baked knowledge, we are semi-knowledgeable. We are almost becoming loose to ourselves. We will not be behaving in that manner before the public. You will not give them confidence of your level that you will be cured. I am giving the treatment and come here once every week, once a month, continuously take the medicine, you will be all right. All those things, false hopes we will not be giving to the patients. Speak to them directly, whether you can cure or not, I cannot. First thing, don't believe me and come. I tell my patients not to believe me and come. Believe in yourself and then come. What is believing in yourself? I can believe myself because I know who I am. I can believe myself. I know who I am. I can't believe myself because I know who I am. I cannot make another one to believe me by giving false hopes. This is where we are undermining our ability, God's providence, to get away from us. So we will not be able to achieve whatever you want, but we may be acquiring certain problems along with it. My confidence levels grows lower and lower, not even hope level. Now I am a dejected person, no patient comes to me. Confidence should not be there from this moment onwards. You are believing in the mundane knowledge, the worldly knowledge, whatever you acquired in your past days, the dead past. We are living in the graveyard. If I hope upon my knowledge, I am living in the graveyard. I am not living anymore in the present world, live around the future. Believe in yourself means, it's a very important part that we have come. Belief in yourself. What is yourself? I got a body, physical nature, that's got a frame, that's got a boundary. Silhouette, the boundary level, I know there's a person sitting down there. Now the focus light is upon me, my vision is dimmed, I can see the silhouettes. I see a lot of people sitting down without any specificity attached to it. I am not able to see clearly, no demarcation, no finer aspects I'm seeing, but silhouettes. I know there's a defined shape, there's a border within which something is there, a human being, male and females, children. This is what I am able to see physically. That physical nature is what knowledge is all about. Unless something is seen, I cannot believe. Unless something is visible to my all five special senses, external senses, I cannot believe in anything. This is science. Seeing is believing is science. If you cannot see, you cannot believe. That means I have no inherent distinguishing ability. Think, pondering, then comprehending, discerning power I am losing. Think well within you for anything. That thinking is formless. It will develop into a concrete shape. Any formless thing, when it develops into a concrete shape, you are so definite that this is the thing of my nature, my requirement, and if I use it, it is going to be effective. Until such time it gets clarity, my thinking gets clarity from confusion, I have no authority to say anything positively. I cannot make anyone understand anything of what I am saying unless I have the clarity. And when I have the clarity, I will be living by it. I will not say one thing and do another thing. I can only speak to you what I am practicing, what is true. Truth and faith will go together. You have a body, you will know very well. Yes, I have a body. Eyes have got a shape, that's a body, part of the body. Hands have a shape, that's a part of a body. Likewise, all external organs and internal organs, you will know there are some shape and size. So there is a parts inside the body. This I believe. There's no need to believe when you see it. Belief means seeing, believing what you cannot visualize through your eyes, visually see through your eyes. Belief is that. Belief in the unseen, that's the belief. Believing in what is visible things, it's not a belief, it's already there, there's no need to believe. So I have my body, and then I have my life force. We call it Uyir. In Hindi you call it Jaan, or in Urdu you call it Jaan. Pranam you can call it, so different names. But in English, there's no name for pranam, for uyir. And a life force, they say, but the life force is a general term. There's no specific terminology in English for uyir. Jaan or pranam, whatever you call it. There is no specific English word for that. If the life force, pranam, is important. I will use the word pranam or uyir because there's no English word for that. If uyir is more important, if pranam is more important, then body has no value at all. It is the pranam that conducts your body, that nourishes your body, that gives activity to your body. Yes? Without pranam, without uyir, there is no life. You are dead. So to understand this, you have to think beyond what I have understood. Beyond the knowledge, you have to think. The knowledge is visible part. Yes, the body. Body is saved by the uyir or prana. Now I am using the word life force for uyir or prana. Or jaan, I use the word life force, uyir. The life force is conducting your bodily parts. When the life force leaves, you are dead. We understand this? If there is a disease in the life force, then its effect will be shown in the particular organs. The life force, if it is so important for your entire body to be alive, when certain part of the body doesn't function, the life force is weak. When you start disease in certain parts of the body, that means your life force is affected. For my eyes, there's a separate life force. For my eyebrows, a life force different. For my hands, the life force is different. For my liver, spleen, likewise, every single organ, every single tissue, every single cells, the life force is different. We are now elevating ourselves from the bodily level to the unseen part of the reality. We have to understand now life force is important to cure a patient, not the bodily parts. In acupuncture, you are using maximum anatomy, bodily parts. You have some hopes in it, so it is working. Your knowledge is not working. Your confidence is not working. Your hope attached to it, which we cannot say what it is by way of your linguistic skills. That hope is giving you the relief to the patient, giving you the desired effect on the patient. That hope is seen through your eyes. And I am not dejected while seeing a doctor when I am seeing his hopeful eyes. This eye contact is important. Not false eye contact, but the true, real eye contact. The inner eye is here. If it believes, if it hopes, that part is contacted here. A false hope will not be given when you are confident about the knowledge alone. Knowledge is removed. Top is removed. Here's the insight. Mind is now working for you. If you know that the small children gathering the knowledge and then beginning to speak at the age of 10 months, 11 months, or one year, 1.5 years, they're beginning to speak, not because you are tuitioning them, but because they are discerning here, understanding everything. Before they begin to communicate, they know very well what they want to communicate, and it is turned into syllables, and they begin to speak. We are not teaching the children, they are understanding it. The only communication between the parents and the child is the eye contact. When I am very angry at the child, it knows that father is angry, I have to keep quiet. When I am so jovial and jolly mood, it understands my father is in jolly mood, so I can do whatever I want, mischief I can do. So they understand through the communication, not by your word of mouth. They understand through the eye contact. This eye contact delivers so many messages, so much of confidence and hope. Whatever you have here, that is transmitted there. If I have hopes, that hope is transmitted. If I have confidence, that confidence is transmitted to the patient. That eye contact helps you to cure the patient. It is not your point. It is not your acupuncture point that is curing. Before that, the patient has got some knowledge about you. He has some confidence about you. He has certain cases, and those patients where their near relatives or their friends, they have told about this doctor. This doctor has cured me of this disease. So you have some confidence that we can go to the doctor. If the doctor has hopes in it, beyond that confidence, you get the hope also by eye contact message. So your confidence is doubled now. That gives the life force to generate. Your life force is generated because you are going with some confidence, but the doctor has some hope with him beyond the level. He has elevated beyond the level of his confidence to a unseen force, that is hope. Beyond something is there. He has not identified what it is. That's something he believes because it has worked in certain patients. The patient is able to see that hope from his eyes. His confidence is doubled here. The patient's confidence is doubled here. So he is cured even before you touch him with a needle. The less you ask the patient of their problems, it means the better confidence you have, that means hope has been attached to the confidence, so you don't ask the patient more questions. The more you ask the patient questions, that means you are exhausting the patient, you are exhausting yourself, you don't know what to do, you are only buying time, making certain false contact with the patient's eyes, thinking that the doctor is listening more and more of me, so he will be able to understand and cure me. It is not so. You have already lost your confidence. The more questions you put, you have lost your confidence already. So the more questions you are asking the patient, you are buying time, not knowing what to do. This is how the patients are getting cured. From an unseen force, the patient is getting a power, that is the life force. At this stage, we have to understand two things. I am losing my hope. I have my hopes. Which will give you strength? I have lost my hopes. I have my hope. of these, which of these will give you strength and which of these will it make you further weaken? I have lost hopes. I am weakened now. My disease will grow worse. How many needles you can put on him? All the 360 needles you put on him, it is not going to work. You must have a hope above the confidence. If at all you want to give some relief to the patient, hope must be there, confidence must not be there. Confidence is what you know, hope is what you don't know. That humility is appreciated by the mighty power. So you have been given some solace in that the patient is getting a cure. Some patient who valued more and who were very hopeful, when they leave you, they get better. It is not the point again. Don't believe in acupuncture. Don't believe in allopathy. Don't believe in any knowledge of material standards. Believe in your heart. Believe in your mind. This life force is important. The life force cannot be seen. The life force cannot be explained. The life force cannot be experimented. And the life force cannot be reproduced by the people. The science becomes absent here. Science cannot enter here when we shift our balance towards unseen. Science is absolute filth when it comes to the mind level. Don't follow the garbage anymore. I am using hard words so that you will understand. No more knowledge but hope. I am edging about knowledge. Definitely you will be more confident. That means more than the confidence level. Hope is attached. With this hope I am seeing the patient, they are getting a cure. This is how in every system of medicine, whatever be the practitioners of whichever system, Ayurveda, Siddha, Unani, acupuncture, allopathy. In allopathy also so many cases are cured by so many doctors. It is because at that point of time when they see the patient, they had certain hopes beyond confidence. Beyond their applicable knowledge, they had got some unseen powers with them at that point of time. So those patients are cured very rarely. Nobody can claim that this system is better, that system is worse. Your system is all right or not, that's important. Your mind system is all right or not, that's important. Your eye contact is now exhibiting the inner sense, insight or not, that's important. That exhibition is important. Your eyes are the tool to instill more confidence, more than the confidence, hope. You will practice when you go from here, not the knowledge, not the acupuncture. You touch any point, it will work if you have hope. Don't worry about the points. Don't worry about which point, element, all those things. Just leave it off. You touch him with hope, you kick him, he will be all right. Don't worry about the points. This is true. Don't even have to touch him if you elevate yourself above the hope level, which I am going to touch later on. At this point, if you have hope, kick him. He kicked me and I became all right. He has got great powers. That's what he will say. He has got some God-given providence. They will say that also. When that hope comes to them, that gives energy, generating the life force in them. That life force is curing the diseases. Don't think that you can demolish the suffering organ by touching and squeezing and pricking, you can cure it. There's absolutely no way for curing a disease because bodily organs or the diseased organs survived by the life force. The bodily organs are survived by the life force. They give energy for surviving and living and then coming back to its original level of functional level. You will have hopes more than the confidence. Now I am saying there's a life force in you, unseen life force, which you cannot see but you can perceive. Yes, I know there is a life force, but nobody can see it. this is important, or the visible body is important now. Affected organ is important, and you are going to deal with the organ, or you are going to the life force that is controlling the organs, functional level, which is important. Only now, the more I ask questions within me, the answer I am getting is going to be the lively force. Any answer that comes from me gives the clarity of thought. That clarity of thought gives solace to my heart, and my eyes are bright. Whoever comes before me, they will not be having any problems before me. When they go out of me, they may have problems. They will say, when I go to the doctor, I am okay, but when I come out, so many things are topsy-turvy. Believe now. Go beyond hopes, believe. Believe, there's no luck playing a part, but definitely some force is playing. Life force, when it is generating, it's a force more than the life force. If my belief creates a life force in me, generates a life force in me, makes my feel stronger in the need I have that I must be cured, that is strengthened by my belief. That means this life force is controlled by the belief. Life force is generated by the belief. Within these two unseen powers, belief saves you, disbelief and unbelief ditches you. Don't be crestfallen by still holding on to the hopes and confidence. Confidence is removed already. Confidence is knowledge. Knowledge is about the dead past, whatever I have gathered in my past. Knowledge is that I am living in the graveyard. You cannot survive. Hope gives you the life. Without even knowing about what hope is, you are hopeful. That is the reason why we are all still living and why we are hopefully looking forward to the future. God's providence is within you. Only if you can understand that providence will be satisfied about you. You are a man of stature, you are a man of understanding, you are a man of comprehension, and you can be now elevated to the belief level. You will be elevated, and the life force gains strength more. And the life force gains strength, here is the clarity of seeing things, that nothing is going to go wrong when I want something dearly and I am in need of certain positive good things. It cannot go haywire. It will keep you on the straight path. You are going to be all right. There's no other alternative to that word. I am beginning to believe that. So this contact has gains more strength now. That belief you will have to hold today. Once you gain the strength and you see the effectiveness in the patients, you have to be faithful to yourself, not being faithful to your knowledge or your ability. So you will never become proud of the achievements that you may have in your future. The more and more humility you practice, the providence is satisfied with you. Improve your standards. This moment, you will not believe in the knowledge. That means you will not be living in the graveyard. Past knowledge. I want a knowledge for the future, yet to be seen, but it is there. I am hopeful, removing the hope, that is luck I am removing, but definitely there is some power. Your power is acting, that is belief. Now I am coming to the topmost level of understanding. Suppose I ask you, is there a force above you or not? Is there a power above you or not? All-encompassing power, almighty power, is there above you or not? What you would say? We are all believers in God now. Yes. What is God? Can you give me a definition to God? Or you will say, only we can feel God, we cannot give definition. You can feel God or you can see God. Who can say I can see God. Who can say, well, no, I can only feel there is godliness? Which of this is right? I want to see you answering this question by lifting your hand. God is a superior most power, a power above me, the mighty power. Right? There's no doubt in it. That's what I believe and upon which I have my faith. Such a superior power, the greatest mighty power, can you see that power through these evil eyes? This mundane eyes, such a weak eyes, I cannot see even this light. I cannot see the sun. The Creator who created all these things, can we see Him through our eyes? Or you can only feel the greatness and godliness of it. Raise your hands. Who can say we can only feel the godliness, cannot see? Now tell me, who says I can see God through these eyes? Raise your hands. Cannot. This is the truth. Final truth, from the confidence level we have raised to hopeful level, now belief, now faith. I have come to the truth level now. That God, where He is, if I am asking you, He is everywhere. That's your answer, right? Okay. What we are doing now in our society is, the godliness alone we can feel. Feeling is here, not there, not there, not anywhere else. But we say God can be there anywhere, everywhere, except here. I am saying God is only here, nowhere else. Every soul, God is there. It is He who makes you understand now about the unseen aspect of life. Don't worry about the body. Body is cared for by the life force. The life force now is survived by what? What saves the life force? What guards the life force? What gives energy to the life force? It is the mind in which you want certain things as your need. If it is fulfilled, you will want to live. If it is not fulfilled, you will not be wanting to live. I want a beautiful life here, untouched by sorrow, grief, anger, despair. I don't want my life to suffer. My life to suffer, not the body. My life to suffer. You want to live by your body or you want to live by your life force? There is a life force, the life of my life force, Uyir Varkai. There is a life of my body, Udal Varkai. Yedu Saryanadu, which is right. Life force, I want to live with my life force intact, or I want to live a bodily life. I want to live a life force intact with my body. That life force is important. You will say, my heart is defective. You will say, my lungs are defective. My liver is defective. So I go to a doctor who is specialist in heart, to a doctor specialist in lungs, chest. I go to a specialist who is specialist in kidney, because I think if a kidney is corrected, my life will be all right. I will be saved. So all these doctors fail, and you know that you are going to die. Now you will say, save my life, oh God. Don't, you will not say, save my kidney, save my liver, save my... All those things you will not see. All the bodily parts are now forgotten. Save my life. From the beginning, it should be there with you. Save my life. Don't worry about your head, your nose, your eyes, ears, kidney and all those things. The more you involve yourself with all these organs, you are dead already because you are believing in the knowledge. Sans life force. Without life force, if you want anything, it is already dead. there is a mosquito, there is an elephant. For this mosquito, the life force is different. For the elephant, the life force is different. That life force creates that elephant structure. For the mosquito, her life force is by the different form of life force that creates its own wings, its own beak and its legs, unseen. Very closely we have to see the structure of it. The life force is different to each organism. The life force is different to each being, animal or man. In every one, the life force is different. That creates only that form. If I got my eyes, it has got a definite shape and size. Nose, likewise, all the organs have got different shapes and size. So it has got separate life force for the eyes, separate life force for the nose, separate life force for the ears. So you have to be very careful. The life force to that particular organ is affected, and I have to give life force to it. I have to safeguard the life force in it. I cannot allow it to weaken any further. Every word is important here. You are forgetting acupuncture from this moment onwards. You are giving more weight, more respect to the life force, which creates your bodily force. God created the life force, not you. There is life force, right? Whoever believes in God, whoever don't believe in God, I hope everybody believes in God. There may be some atheists who may not be believing in God. For them also, the answer should be suitable to them. I have my life force or not? Yes, I have my life force. Forget about the people who already believe in the God. I am talking this only to those who cannot believe in God. So there is a life force. எனக்கு உயிர் இருக்குது, ஆமாம். பார்க்க முடியுமா? I cannot see. But is it there? Yes, it is there. So much is sufficient. Their knowledge is working. Their power of understanding is working now. That life force, if you cannot see, if it is there, who created the life force? It came from nothingness, or someone, the designer, the fashioner, the creator created it? Yes, I don't believe in the creator, but some other force is there above it to create this. Whatever is created is lower level, whatever creates is higher level. Is there a power high above these creations? Yes, there is a power high above the creations. That I understand. This is the answer of the atheists who cannot believe in God. Don't use the God, the word God. Is it a power or not? Power is there. Can you see? Cannot see. But this power is maintained by, created and maintained by some other power. It is not you who created the life force, but something else created the life force. So I believe in that life force. Yes? This is the God's mighty power. I believe in that God's mighty power. That mighty power is the godliness, right? I don't want God. I want the godliness, His power. If He is able to confer it upon me, if He is able to bless it upon me, I want the power, not the God. If somebody does some ashirvad to you, blessings to you, you want the person or the blessings? If somebody, a person of high standards, giving you some blessings, you want the blessing or the person himself? Blessing. So when God blesses you, take the blessing, don't keep the God with you. You cannot have God with you. Have His blessings and start functioning in the way He guides you. The problem with us is we are making God as an idol. But God says, I am not an idol. I created the life force which cannot be seen. I created the entire thing, the creative power you cannot see. That power is godliness. You have the godliness in you. You wish for the godliness in you, but you want to see the God whom you can never see. So you have to imagine the God and create the gods. We are idol worshipping by creating the gods. I am the first one from my family to dissociate myself from the idol worshipping, going to mosque. I will not. I must know who Allah is. Unless I know Allah, I cannot worship. Unless you know God, you cannot go worship God. Who will teach you about? The priesthood will teach you? No, God himself will teach you. About God, God has to teach you. About God's way, he must be your guide, not the priesthood. They have never seen the God. Nobody can see the God. It is a feel, whether you feel the godliness or not. Yes, I feel the godliness. There is one God I have understood. I have pinpointed him, he is there. Now you understand godliness is there. He is the one, he gives you, imparts you knowledge to understand beyond your scope of understanding, beyond all your intelligence. You are understanding God himself. This is a great achievement in your life now. I know there's a God. There's no further achievement other than this. You are straight away on the zenith of the entire world system. The world is now under your feet. Nothing in this world should be worshipped. Nobody else can teach you who God is, except only when you know, when you understand, when you discern, when you comprehend. Because you are thinking inside. If I am asking outside through my mouth, all confusion exists. When I ask the same question inside, confusion is clarified. Have the clarity of knowledge by asking in you. Don't ask anyone else what is not visible before your eyes. Signs can be imparted. S-I-G-N, sign. The sign of God, I am understanding. I am now receiving much better knowledge about my unseen powers. This is what is going to be effective to me and to my society at large. You are receiving the greatest guidance of all times. You have nothing to boast, to boost your life here. You have to maintain your humility to the maximum level. You are a patient before a patient, because I don't know. I have lost my hopes. At least the patient has come with some hope. I have no hope at all. I am worse than a patient. With this, I am seeing the patient. Will he survive? He cannot. So have your hopes now. Destroy your confidence level. That self-confidence must be removed. Belief in the faith is important. So ascend up, transcending yourself above all obstacles. I have no idol worshipping from this moment onwards. I have only godliness in me, the blessings in me. Have the blessings. All of you are suffering from something or other, either financially or family problems or internal stress or disease physically. We are all suffering. At the same time, there is another word, you should be all right. Suppose there is a pain here, okay, in my little finger, index finger. Is this the part that's speaking with his mouth that I am paining, or here it says pain is there? Which one is speaking as pain here? This finger is speaking, or here it is spoken, the pain is there? Who says it is the heart that speaks about the pain? Who says if the finger is speaking, there is pain? You've got a lot of senses. In fact, it has not been ignited. Today, it has been given life. You will not see the idols. That is anything that is in shape. Without life force, this is dead. Life force is generated from here because of the belief. So the life force is here. There is a pain here, this says. Yes, there is a pain here. At the same time, here another word is there. Don't worry, it should be all right. Who speaks those words? Is it there or not? It's a feel. Don't worry, it should be all right. It should be all right. You should be cured. Here it says, or as I am speaking to you, somebody else speaking to you through your ears and then goes there inside the heart. Or inside the heart it says, don't worry, it should be getting better, it should be removed, you should be healed, you should be cured. Who says here? It's you? Or something else above you? From above you it has come. You say, I will not be cured. We are rejecters of that godliness. The blessing has come here. From where? From the mighty source, whatever has created you, from him the blessing has come there. Take the blessings. Don't take blessings from the people. They themselves don't know what blessing is. Simply by word of mouth they will say, even if that gives some hope, we will have some encouragement from that. Maximum when a person gives you some blessing, it is to the hope level only. That is hopeless. Because belief is important, thereafter faith is important, and the attainment of truth is important, there you stand. That truth speaking to you, the God speaks to you, get well. Tell me now, discern carefully. In your heart there are two things, one opposing the other. One thing is you are opposing the God. God says the moment you are suffering from something, don't worry, but we worry. It will be cured. How can it be cured? This is some disease the people have said that this is a worst form of disease, you will not be cured. But there is a clear word, get cured. It should be cured. One single word, unambiguous word, with no two ways about it, get cured. Who can say that except the one who created you? So listen to that. Hold on to that. Your answer should be now. When he says, it is he who says, get well, which is not within your parameters, but you need it. So you are a fakir before that word, the blessings. You are a slave to the word. So you must be a slave to the godliness. Say, I am slave to every need God gives me. I am slave to that godliness. I am slave to the godliness. Every attribute of God becomes your godliness, and you are slave to the godliness. Will you abide by this? I have nothing to become proud. I have nothing to bombast, boast, hated by everybody, not only God, even the people around you will hate you for your pride, for your arrogance. So I have to be very humble before the people if you want God to safeguard you, guide you to the fullest part of your life until your last breath. You will accept it. Stay humble. Don't become proud just because a few money you have earned. Money will be lost. But the self cannot be lost on any account. Keep up yourself and keep close to belief and faith. Be faithful to your soul. Do not believe in anything that is seen. Because all those things are already dead and gone. The moment you are born, you are progressing towards your death. So the moment you are born, physical form, that is growing 1 year old, 2 year old, 20 year old, 50 year old, you are going towards your death. Countdown is taking place. This is what you are celebrating as birthdays. Many, many more such countdowns can come today. Many, many happy turns of the day, die today itself. This is a death day celebration or birthday celebration, you will understand. Don't follow the people, ugly people. Don't follow their ways. Don't go for recreation. Don't enlighten yourself by seeing the pomp and show. No fun and sport for us, but be serious. Be self-oriented. I am not saying selfishness, self-oriented. Whatever is clear here, I am oriented towards that. Whatever be the antagonistic views of the public throughout the world, I am least bothered about it. As long as you are an individual, stay as an individual. Don't become a collective herd, losing your individual status. We are lost now. We have become cattle. We are not yet created, we are not yet advanced ourselves as human beings. So come up with yourself. So believe in yourself and seek forgiveness if you have confidence. Oh God, I don't want this sign, S-I-S-C-I-E-N-C, I want this sign of you. It is the science versus sign. The godliness is the sign that gives my energy, that gives my liveliness, that gives and generates my life force, and that will cure the bodily parts. Suppose I have some severe eye problem. They say that your eyesight will go. Who says? A specialist. A specialist's job is to cut and remove. If you say any problem in any organ, he cannot cure. So if you are going to be totally disease-free in the hands of all of the doctors, the moment you are born, you should be killed. You will not be having any disease in the coming future. This is not the way. One single sentence is sufficient. These people, the allopathic people, are substandard. They can only have confidence. They cannot even have hope. That is the lowest level. Acupuncture I can put between hope and belief level. All the other categories I can put between the confidence and hope level. This is how you will categorize. Yet, acupuncture is not sufficient. You must firmly perched upon the belief, thereafter you will be elevated to your faithful status. Only God is there for your help. Now there is an eye problem. I gave you an instance. This gives me a lot of worry. What if my sight goes away? What if I become blind? But there is a word there. Your sight must be returned in a kiparvai vendum. I want my sight back. Is it there or not? If suppose you suffer from any disease, instantly, even before you negate it, there is a word in you, very feeble, it is there, get well. Where from it has come? It has come from the providence. The sound must grow greater and greater, and you must start concentrating on that more than anything else that people will speak about that particular disease. This disease, no, cannot be cured, but who says he should be cured? I believe. Be a believer. Don't believe the scientific people. They are idol worshipping. Whatever is visible, they will understand, they will believe. What is not visible, they cannot believe. But what is not visible is your life force. The very life force is essential for your entire life of 80 years to 100 years. The life force is not to be seen. That life force, the allopathic medicine doesn't know. Any system of medicine doesn't know about the life force. So will you believe in the life force now, or will you believe in the idol? Without life force, your body is a statue. You have become an idol. Yes? You are dead one, right? Deadlock, without life force. Satta jalandana. I don't want to be a dead man, but I want to be a living force. So start believing in the good things that is given to you by the highest seat of power. He is there in you, in everyone. So I cannot be boastful before you, you cannot be boastful before me. One will be competing with another in being humble and showing humility. If you listen to me, I am speaking only with reverence to the truth I possess. It is not a show from me to you. If it is a show from me to you, you cannot understand anything I am saying. If it is truthfully spoken to you, you will know, with all reverence to the Almighty Power, I want to deliver some good out of me from whatever I am living through. Don't do idol worshipping. You cannot imagine God when you cannot see God. You cannot imagine a blessing when the blessing is there as godliness. You want godliness, you don't want God. Don't be praying, be prayerful all the time. So whatever God has blessed you with, be prayerfully accepting it and strengthen it without casting any doubt to it. Never doubt any good things. If at all you doubt it based on your knowledge. Such things I have not heard, I will not be cured of my cancer. Such things I have not heard, I don't think that this person can be saved. So only when you know of the past that has happened, you will be believing this. Is it right on our part? God created you from nothingness. Let us go to the real creation of yours. God created you from nothingness, right? Even before you were a gamete, a small cell, one single cell, gamete, God created you even before you were created. This is the truth. And from that, you grow up to 6-footer with good physique and mind, everything God created inside it, placing every single organ in its right position, in its right measure, and in its right weight, and in its proper function He put into it. Which one of these you will deny? Don't follow those who preach you about God in form and shape. Stay within you, receive the blessing, have the godliness in you, and start flourishing in this world and in the next world. You want the blessing, not God Himself. Don't worry about which God, which form and shape. We have created all this God. So we are the creator of this God, and I am the God of gods. No God above me. This is the reason why we are not able to gain anything from our prayers. Godliness is in you. Safeguard your heart. Safeguard your bosoms. Purify it from saying anything against the blessings. Because you value your knowledge more than the blessing. But you want blessing. Such a confusion. You want blessing or your knowledge? Then why do you give any value to that knowledge? Stay humble. Don't show yourself as high above the providence here, the godliness here. You want godliness, not God. Entering into a mosque, entering into a church, entering into a temple, just avoid it. Enter here. God is speaking to you here. So deep inside He is speaking to you. It's a blessing. Where else you want to go? Only the priesthood made us come out of this and enter into the construction buildings. There you are lost. You go there and you, certain people say, because I went there, I have some peace of mind. The Hindus say, I went to temple, I have some peace of mind, right? They will say, I went to church. And the Muslims will say, I will go to mosque and I have my peace. Going there, what you do? I pray, I meditate. You went there to see God, right? You went there to see God, but once you start praying, once you start worshipping, you are closing your eyes or not? Who closed your eyes? It is not God, it is not the place. When you are closing your eyes, the whole world is gone. You are turning here. That is the reason you are having your comfort and solace to your heart. Not because you have entered this religion, this building and that building. Don't follow the priesthood, follow yourself. God created man, okay? Not Hindu man, Muslim man, Christian man. If you attach yourself to, I am Hindu, I am Muslim and Christian, then you are not a human being anymore, something else. You have not divided the human society, but you have slaughtered and divided God Himself as Hindu God, Muslim God, and Christian God. Something heinous crime that we are committing to our own soul. I am not touching upon the religion. I am touching upon being religious to your duty. Be religious. Don't stick to any religion. Religious to truthfulness. Be religious to your truthfulness. Keep up that truthfulness in you. Don't follow God. Keep up godliness in you. Don't pray. Be prayerful all the time. So all are not physical forms of worshipping, but mental form of attaching ourselves close to the heart, close to God, so that godliness gives the entire formation, new creation around you. There is no disease before you, but except that whom he wills. When God wills on someone, he will be cured, and it is not for you to say you will be cured when the patient comes to you. When the patient comes to me, they want to come to me, they will ask me, Sir, Irevadi Marthon Soringe Sogamahama. It is God's blessing upon you, it is there. If you believe that, it will be all right, you'll be all right. If you believe me, you will not be all right. Don't believe me and come. Believe your godliness, and even before you're coming here, you will be all right. Don't insinuate me to God. Don't make me a God. There is no link between you and me when you are cured. It is a link between you and yourself, where God speaks to you, which you accepted it as a reward from God. Because of the acceptance, you get better. Stay humble. My time is over. Be not confident. Be not hopeful, but be a believer. Raise yourself to the faith level. Godliness is there. Don't imagine God anymore. Be prayerful. Don't be praying with your bodily structure. God will see your mind when you are praying him, worshiping him, or he will see your body. Then why do you show your body and do bodily worshiping? What happened to the mental worshiping? Knowing well, why do you physically fall before him and then I have done my prayer, everything. You are committed a great sin to yourself. Start believing now. Don't fall making your structure that I am falling before my God. God sees your heart, sees the blessings, whether you are holding, revering it or not. He doesn't see your body. He is unwilling to see your body. Who will say God sees only my body, not my mind? I can cheat my God by acting before him. Cannot. So be worthy of yourself. Don't follow another person physically, but follow some person who are elevated from physical nature, being hopeful, belief, and who are edging upon the faith towards truthfulness. Have rapport with him. That will strengthen your life for yourself, your family, and generations. So with this, you will have a prayer. Whatever goodness I have in me is the godliness, your blessing. I am accepting it. Strengthen my acceptance, O my God. Now you are saying, O my God, he is elsewhere. I do not know where he is, but his godliness is there. But he can hear me when I am supplicating to him. Strengthen my belief, increase in my faith, and never allow me to go astray doing idol worshipping. I will never worship anything that is in form and shape, but I will go here only to strengthen my liveliness, life force, and belief in you, so that I will ever be grateful to you for having given this beautiful mind and soul to me. I will be soulfully yours from this moment onwards. With this, we conclude. Thank you so much.